The 2023 Kia Niro's second generation marks a significant shift in the model's powertrain lineup. The Niro EV stands out as the top performer, with a 201 horsepower front-mounted electric motor. The two gasoline-electric options, however, have different horsepower ratings. The standard Niro hybrid features a 104 horsepower 1.6-liter four-cylinder engine and a 43 horsepower electric motor, producing a combined output of 139 horsepower. On the other hand, the more expensive Niro plug-in hybrid, PHEV, boasts a powerful 83 horsepower motor, resulting in a total of 180 horsepower. In addition to its capability of driving solely on electric power for a certain distance, the PHEV also offers improved performance, with its 7.3 second acceleration from 0 to 60 miles per hour and a 5.0 second increase in speed from 50 to 70 miles per hour. The PHEV offers satisfactory performance. In comparison, the Niro hybrid is slower, reaching the same marks in a leisurely 8.9 seconds for 0 to 60 miles per hour and 6.2 seconds for a 50 to 70 miles per hour increase in speed. When driving the Niro hybrid, overtaking slower traffic requires a bit more thought and preparation. Pushing the accelerator results in the small four-cylinder engine working hard to reach its red line at 6,000 revolutions per minute. It must be acknowledged that neither the Niro hybrid nor the PHEV is particularly thrilling to drive. Kia tries to infuse some sportiness into both Niros by including a sport drive mode, but this mode only leads to a minor improvement in accelerator response, a heavier steering feel, and the ability to manually control the six-speed gearbox through the use of paddle shifters. If you opt for the default Eco mode, the accelerator will respond to inputs in a lethargic manner, the steering effort will feel more natural, and the steering wheel mounted paddles will be used to adjust the level of regenerative braking. Regardless of the drive mode selected, the long travel brake pedal of both Niros blends the vehicle's regenerative and mechanical braking functions in a predictable and progressive manner. Both the Niro Hybrid and PHEV models are better suited for urban driving environments. This is due to the 125 and 150 pound-feet of torque generated by the Hybrid and PHEV's respective electric drive motors, which provide a decent level of low-speed acceleration. Additionally, their cabins are quieter during city driving. Compared to the highway driving noise, the Hybrid model is particularly noisy, registering 73 decibels at 70 miles per hour, which is 3 decibels louder than the PHEV and 5 decibels louder than its predecessor. There is little difference in the interiors of the two Niros. The production hybrid model now features a T-handle shifter while the PHEV has a rotary-style shifter. The pre-production cars had a 10.3-inch instrument cluster screen, but the final production models come with a smaller 4.3-inch information display surrounded by digital gauges. The full digital single-element display is reserved for the Niro EV model only. Although the new Niro is 2.5 inches longer and has a 0.8 inch longer wheelbase than its predecessor, it still has the same amount of storage space for carry-on size suitcases, which is 6 with all seats in use and 18 with the rear seatbacks folded. The Niro Hybrid has additional storage space under the floor, which the PHEV uses to accommodate its larger battery. On the other hand, the rear seat legroom has increased by more than 2 inches compared to the previous Niro model, The 2023 Niro Hybrid starts at a price of $28,000. The PHEV model starts off at the X level and does not offer an entry-level LX trim. When comparing the X trim of the PHEV with the X trim of the hybrid, the PHEV's premium is only $5,000, which is considered reasonable considering the increased electric-only driving range, power, and acceleration it offers over the hybrid. Thus, the PHEV model justifies its higher price compared to the less powerful hybrid model. Thank you for watching.